Hello students, in the last lecture we discussed about parts of speech and in today's lecture we will be discussing sentence rearrangement. Students, in sentence rearrangement, you will be given four sets of sentences. And all those four sets of sentences will be in the form of jumbled words. The sentence will not be given in a meaningful manner. You have to make it in a meaningful manner. It will be given in the form of jumbled words. Right? For example, suppose I am an English teacher. This is how the sentence should be. But in the question, it might be given as teacher am English I am. Like this. You have to frame your answer in this format. In the question, it might be given as this. This is called sentence rearrangement. Correct? Now, there are certain rules which you need to follow while rearranging the sentences. Okay? Students, every sentence is of the following format. It follows the following format, that is subject, verb and object. This is called SVO format of a sentence. First of all, there is subject, then there is verb, and then there is a object, right? कोई भी सेंटेंस इसी फॉर्मेट में लिखा जाता है, right? Second rule, a sentence usually but not always starts with an article, we already know, a and the, right, or noun or adjective. Most of, not always, but most of a sentence usually starts with either an article or a noun or adjective. Noun you already know. Name, place, thing, animal, bird, insect. In sabke common ya proper nouns. Adjectives, these are describing words which describe the noun or the nature of the noun. Third rule. A sentence can end with full stop, question mark, or exclamatory mark. Now, students, a sentence ending with a full stop is called a declarative or an assertive sentence. If it ends with a question mark, it is called an interrogative sentence. And if it ends with an exclamatory mark, it is called an exclamatory sentence. Now, in your 10th standard exams, exclamatory and interrogative sentences will not be asked in sentence rearrangement. Is topic ke andar, इंट्रोगेटिव और एक्सक्लेमेटरी सेंटेंसेस नहीं पूछे जाएंगे. सो दैट इज व्हाई यू कैन ओनली राइट दैट अ सेंटेंस कैन एंड विथ अ फुल स्टॉप, राइट. एंड द लास्ट रूल विच इज मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट, दैट फर्स्ट सेंटेंस will be solved, it will be a clue to the second sentence, and the first two sentences will be clues to the third sentence, and so on. Students, understand this point very carefully. The first sentence will be given as salt. It will be a clue to the second sentence. And जो पहले दो sentence है, मतलब first solved और जो आप second sentence solve करोगे, ये पहले दो sentence they will be the clues to the third sentence. इसी तरह से पहले तीन सेंटेंस विल बी अ क्लू टू द फोर्थ सेंटेंस. दैट मीन्स ऑल ऑफ दीज सेंटेंसेस विल बी रिलेटेड टूगेदर, एंड आफ्टर यू फ्रेम ऑल द फोर सेंटेंसेस यू कैन रीड देम आउट एंड इट विल बिकम अ पैराग्राफ, करेक्ट. सो प्लीज नोट डाउन दीज रूल्स स्टूडेंट्स, देन वी शैल प्रोसीड टू द एक्सरसाइज ऑफ दिस टॉपिक. students, these are the first four sentences. As I told you, the first sentence will be solved for you. Okay, so I am solving this sentence for you. अभी सॉल्व करने से पहले, as I have told you the rule, every sentence should either bring with a noun or pronoun, or it should begin with adjective or article. तो यहाँ पे noun है Martha, right? So it will begin with Martha. So Martha subject है, फिर उसके बाद आता है verb. तो ये having is having, ठीक है? फिर क्या होता है उसको difficulty. किस चीज में ऑब्जेक्ट क्या है? स्लीपिंग लेटली. सो मार्था इज हैविंग. तो दिस इज सब्जेक्ट, दिस इज वर्ब. ऑब्जेक्ट इज डिफिकल्टी, राइट? नाउ डिफिकल्टी इन व्हाट? सो दैट कंटिन्यूज एज द पार्ट ऑफ द सेंटेंस, स्लीपिंग लेटली. नाउ दिस सेंटेंस becomes a clue to the second sentence. अब Martha को difficulty होती है sleeping में, उसकी वजह से क्या होता है? तो second sentence में the noun or pronoun is she, दूसरा है friends, लेकिन बात हो रही है Martha की, तो अपने friends से start नहीं कर सकते, अपने Martha को जो pronoun denote करता है उससे start करेंगे. So we start with she. So she, अब इसमें verb है enjoys, तो क्या वो enjoy करती है? नहीं, enjoy नहीं करती है, क्योंकि उसको difficulty होती है into sleeping. So she no longer enjoys things. अब बाकी क्या बचा? Friends, her और with. इसको आपको थोड़ा rearrange करना पड़ेगा दो तीन words को last में. So it will be with her friends. This you can do with little practice. You can arrange she enjoys and thinks. This is subject, verb and object. फिर आप थोड़ा सोचिए कि क्या वो enjoy कर रही है कि नहीं कर रही है. So this is clear from the first sentence कि वो enjoy नहीं कर रही है. So no longer कहां पे आएगा? Enjoys के पहले, right? क्योंकि वो negative action denote कर रहा है. किसके साथ वो चीजें एंजॉय नहीं कर पाती है? विथ हर फ्रेंड्स. तो वो लास्ट में आएगा. अब ये दोनों चीजें, ये थर्ड सेंटेंस का क्लू है, ठीक है? ये दोनों चीजें क्यों हो रही है? क्योंकि उसके ऊपर बहुत सारा स्ट्रेस है. सो स्ट्रेस इज द नाउन इन द थर्ड सेंटेंस. सो स्ट्रेस, अब उसकी वजह से क्या हो रहा है? स्ट्रेस हैज वॉन, has worn. Worn मतलब पूरी तरह से उसको अंदर से स्ट्रेस की वजह से तकलीफ हो रही है. So stress has worn her out completely. Correct? अब ये तीनों सेंटेंस जो है, ये फोर्थ के लिए आंसर है. फोर्थ का आंसर आपको इन तीन के रेफरेंस से लिखना. तो अब अगर स्ट्रेस बहुत ज्यादा बढ़ गया है, सोने में तकलीफ हो रही है, लाइफ एंजॉय नहीं कर पा रही है, सो डेफिनेटली शी विल नीड अ मेडिकल रेफरेंस. सो नाउ शी विल नीड, राइट, ऑफ आएगा, शी विल नीड हेल्प ऑफ मेडिकल रेफरेंस. सो दिस इज द आंसर ऑफ द फोर्थ सेंटेंस. नाउ शी विल नीड हेल्प ऑफ मेडिकल रेफरेंस. तो शी जो है ये नाउन, विल नीड एंड हेल्प इज ऑब्जेक्ट. फिर किसका हेल्प? ये तीन वर्ड्स रहते हैं, इनको रीअरेंज करना पड़ता है, ठीक है? इसमें नाउ अगर आप पीछे लिखते हो तो भी राइट होगा, She will need help of medical reference now. That will also be correct. So there can be more than one correct answers to a sentence. Please note down these things, students. And be very careful, students. Mistakes are not allowed. Be very careful in writing. And write questions and answers both. Now these are the next four sentences. Please note down the questions and try to solve on your own. This can be solved very easily. T is considered as the best beverage in the वर्ल्ड. बेवरेज मतलब ये टी, कॉफी, कोको, ये सब बेवरेज बोलते हैं. इनसे क्या है, हम फ्रेश हो जाते हैं. स्टिम्यूलेंट्स बोलते हैं इनको. स्टिम्यूलेंट पीने से हम थोड़े फ्रेश हो जाते हैं नींद से उठने के बाद. सेकेंड सेंटेंस इट इज रिलेटेड टू द फर्स्ट सेंटेंस थाउजेंड्स ऑफ इयर्स अगो. सो इसमें प्रोनाउन से स्टार्ट करेंगे. इट से सो इट was invented thousands of years ago in China. थर्ड वाला जो है ये थोड़ा बड़ा है. ये कंज्यूम्ड प्रॉपर्टीज की वजह से, मतलब क्यों टी पिया जाता है. तो इसमें भी ये प्रोनाउन इट से स्टार्ट करेंगे. So, it is consumed for its medicinal properties as well as for staying fresh. Correct? ये थोड़ा बड़ा सेंटेंस है लेकिन आप समझ लीजिए. It is consumed for its medicinal properties as well as for staying fresh. This is the answer. And last है, again it will start with its. So it is less harmful than coffee. Coffee जो है उसमें caffeine होता है. Tea is comparatively less harmful than coffee. Please note down these four answers. And please take care in the third sentence. Let's take one more example, students. So this will clear whatever doubts that you have. Now try to solve these four. If you are able to solve them on your own, you can have some grip over the topic right now. This can be sometimes very tricky, but with practice, you will be able to solve the sentences. And we will very soon give you the worksheets related to sentence rearrangement and error correction. Enough worksheet work will be given to you. I am giving you 2 minutes to solve this on your own. So the first sentence, there are two nouns, affair as well as life. So affair is a complex life, it doesn't make any sense. So we have to start with life. So life is a very complex affair. Now, because we have started with life, so second sentence may we have to start with a noun or pronoun which denotes life. So if we can start is it. So it is not as simple as eating and स्लीपिंग. बहुत सारे लोग यही बोलते हैं, खाओ पियो सो जाओ, यही जिंदगी है. पर एक्चुअली में लाइफ इतनी आसान नहीं होती है. एक्चुअली ये हर एक करता है, हर एक क्रीचर करता है. सो एवरी क्रीचर does this in its own way. Correct? Fourth sentence thodi difficult hai. It is about humans. Humans ke liye sirf khao piyo sona nahi hai. Humans ke liye life ko jina har ek opportunity ki tarah hai. Kuch humans bahut zyada successful hote hai. Zyada successful hone ka matlab hai wealth zyada accumulate karna, zyada luxurious life jina, zyada places ghumna. Right? Some people are more privileged than others when it comes to humans. So, but for humans, why we are using but in the beginning? Because humans are differentiated from the other creatures. So every creature does this in its own way, but for humans, life is full of opportunities to improve themselves. Correct? For humans, the life is full of opportunities to improve themselves. Please note down these four sentences. So students, that's it for today. The worksheet for sentence rearrangement will be given after we complete the topic of error correction. So wo dono topics ka worksheet aapko saath mein mil jayega. Right? So in the next lecture, we will take error correction. Till then, goodbye students.